All right, hey guys, Rudy from Ridgeline here. So some of you guys are asking questions about the LPR. So there's a lot kind of going on underneath the hood. And this is probably gonna be a multi-part series just because it's gonna take a little bit of time to kind of dig into some of the nuances. And honestly, even then, I really can't get into just about everything, but I'm gonna cover some of the big questions that a lot of you guys are having. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna jump in over to the Beat Lab. I'm gonna show you guys what's going on kind of in the QC process and some of the different parts and pieces, how we're bringing everything together into the LPR and what makes the LPR what it is. All right, so talking about barrels. So barrels is kind of pretty much the heart of any rifle. And the LPR is kind of no different. So we have our own proprietary barrel relationship with Proof Research. Proof Research cuts all of our barrels. So they are 416 stainless single point cut, and they are cut to our profile well. So our profile is a little bit different than your typical AR-15 barrels that are gonna be out there. Kind of see here, this is a production barrel. It's getting ready to get mated and fitted together. So the barrel extensions are pretty normal. They're a little bit oversized, but they're pretty much, you know, straight up standard AR-15 barrel extension. It's kind of a hybrid between an SPR profile, like the Mark 12, and a standard SOCOM barrel. So it's kind of designed to pull a lot of heat away from the chamber versus having a really thin barrel here where it's not going to pull that much heat. Coming up to the gas block, so we have our own custom gas block that we use. I'll talk about that in a second. But this is also a little bit thicker than, you know, your standard 0.75 gas drill. So this is a 875, so it's a little bit bigger. Again, adding a little bit more meat at what we found to be a very critical point, which is the actual gas port. So you start to get a lot of erosion at the gas port, especially when you push the gun hard, more rapid rates of fire, heavy round counts. And so having a little bit more meat up here to kind of draw the heat and slow the erosion has actually proven to be pretty beneficial for accuracy. That diameter pretty much kind of carries straight out to the rest of the barrel. So this is a 16 inch. Pretty much every LPR right now is a 16 inch. There are more barrel lengths that are coming. So you'll probably see one that bumps up to 18. You may see another one that bumps down to a 14.5. But we start with 16 because a 16 is a pretty good balance across everything. So like I said, these barrels are made for us. Each one comes here. When it comes here, every single barrel gets inspected. So before it's even assembled, it's getting bore scoped. There's a straightness gauge. Like every single aspect of this barrel is double checked to make sure it is perfect before it goes together. Now, I wanted to show you guys one of our prototype barrels. This is an early prototype barrel. So it's very, very similar to the production barrel. So this one, as you can see, this is actually a stainless steel barrel. It did go through nearly 5,000 rounds through the SOCOM surge test. So for those of you guys that don't know, the SOCOM surge testing schedule fires is pretty aggressive. Essentially, you're doing, you know, 8 magazines back to back, one in semi, one in burst, one in semi, one in burst, so forth, all the way through. These guns get almost so hot you can't even hold. So what I like about this barrel is, as you can see, it is a stainless steel barrel, but this thing got freaking cooked. And I like to show this because you can kind of see where a lot of the heat is at. So most of the heat is going to be kind of out here, which is beneficial for us as precision shooters. It's going to make your barrel last a lot longer. So the profile helps draw some of that heat away from the chamber. It's typically the chamber is your highest pressure point. That's where you're going to get the most wear in your rifling. That's going to cause inaccuracies. And our profile helps pull a little bit of that heat out. In addition to that, not only is our barrel helping pull heat, the receiver is pulling that as well. And I'll talk about that here in a second. But as you can see, the idea here is to pull heat away from the chamber to increase reliability, to increase accuracy in the long term. Coming up to the gas block here, this is probably the main point of difference here in this prototype barrel. It's a little bit thinner, but it's pretty much the same structure. So our gas block system that we designed,
We wanted basically a more efficient, cleaner system to run, very similar to the original Knight's LPR. Again, this isn't proprietary or anything. This is a simple jam nut with a taper built into it. It's a 1-inch. You can literally turn this off for an adjustable wrench. Nothing crazy there. And so that threads onto the barrel, basically pinning that taper, pinning into the actual gas block itself, which has a taper as well. That pushes the whole gas block against the rear tapers back here on the barrel shoulder and the concave caper inside of the gas block. Now, this barrel hasn't been cleaned at all. So as you can see, there's really not a lot of gas that is escaping out of the system. Most of the gas, that if it's gonna escape at all, it's gonna come out of the roll pin hole right here. But again, it's about a 90% solution with not much more effort. Another big advantage to having the gas system set up this way is we're not adding any sort of stressors, whether it's a clamp around the barrel or set screws going into the bottom deforming metal. This whole system of the taper with the jam nut pretty much solves any potential issue with that, along with making just a cleaner system. Another thing that we also do here when we're going through the QC process is we take the time to basically gauge every single gas tube as well and ensure the straightness of it. So this is a big point in regarding accuracy that a lot of people don't ever think about. The fact that you might free float a barrel like in the rail, but we also ensure that every single gas tube is also free floated. So when these are getting assembled, we're checking the relationship between the gas tube and the gas key, like in the bolt, to ensure there's no binding or anything.
All right, guys, so that wraps up this segment of the videos. If you have any more questions, go ahead, drop them in the comments. Go ahead, subscribe, like, whatever the fuck we do on the internet nowadays. Like I said, I'm here, ask questions, might get another video.